All right, so how different is my 20-minute power on my TT bike to my road bike? Now, obviously, all of you have been wondering those questions, and I'm sure you haven't had much sleep because of it. But luckily, I have managed to get some data in the last couple of days about my two efforts. So, firstly, I just want to cover left-right balance. Now, this is probably quite boring for most people, but basically, I have had a really bad left-right balance issue. So, like, if we go on this ride, it's like 54-46, which obviously is not very good. However, it seems to have slightly corrected itself on hard efforts. It seems to be pretty close, actually. So for the purpose of this video, I'm actually going to ignore it. The reason I have a left-right balance is because I broke my left femur about a year and a half ago, and it's almost there, but not quite back to what we expect. So we're going to go through the TT data first, then we're going to go on to the climb data. So this is the time trial. It's a 10-mile time trial. Very classic in the UK, 16-ish kilometers. Average speed, 44 and a bit kilometers an hour. Not too bad. Average power, 315 watts. I'm about 60, 61 at the moment. Not quite 59, but so the watts per kilo the displayed here will be at, 0.1 less or so. So anyway, we did 315 watts. Average cadence, 87, which I think is not too bad, for a 20, 21-minute effort or so. Okay, it's not unreal, but it's not bad. It's not bad. And if we had the left right issue, let's say it's like 4%, and that sort of covers it, it might be less, it might be more. I am actually going to get a right hand side only a right hand power meter to add to it as well, which would be pretty decent. But anyway, 314 watts, so not too bad. My FTP is about 320. Now, if we go on to today's effort, actually, I'll show you in Training Peaks first. We haven't had an ideal day. We did have a couple issues with the sleep recently, so we haven't been super fresh. But anyway, that doesn't really matter too much. You just gotta turn up and whack it. So anyway, this is the effort today. 1 second under. You can see the power balance here is very close, so potentially not too much of an issue. But we did 332 watts, I think it was, for the 20 minutes, which wasn't great, I'm not going to lie. So you think originally my difference is about 17 watts. However, I think it could be a bit more, to be honest, because we didn't pace this very well. We did the first 10 minutes at 350 watts or 348, which wasn't ideal. I somehow thought I was going to do my 6 watts per kilo for 20, which is my goal for the year, like now, but obviously that wasn't going to happen. So the first five, we were actually quite calm. The first five here, we were like 344 or so, and then the middle five, we got very excited at 352. The 1500, bam, we were going 15.5 km out, 10%. I thought I was onto it, but obviously it then needs to slow down. But anyway, it wasn't too bad. It wasn't too bad. It was just the last sort of 5 minutes where we really cracked off and did 312 and then 303 for the last 4 minutes. So obviously that wasn't great. However, overall, the difference is not actually too crazy. I'd say, this today we could have done maybe 340, and I think maybe there's a couple percent issue in this. Maybe not when I'm going full gas. It'll be interesting to see, but it's maybe like 5% or so difference, maybe a bit more than that, which I don't think is too bad. You may disagree, but I actually think it's not too hard for me to put power out in the TT position. I always think it is decent. So anyway, those basically the deal at the moment. These are the numbers I'm putting out, and the goal this year is 6 for 20, which you might think is a bit ridiculous considering I did 5.6 today. But well, didn't do 5 points, I did 5.4 actually, because I'm 61 kilos. But losing to 2 kilos isn't too bad. We can get down to 59, just you'll need to watch what we eat for a couple months and we'll be there, so that's no worries. And then the power, I think today we could have done like 340 probably ish, if we just not blown up. And then I've got like about 14 watts to gain, which might sound quite a lot, but I think when I just focus purely on the road bike, and the TT bike a little bit less, and some more high intensity efforts, if we actually look at the efforts I've been doing, they haven't really been okay. We did some 30-15s and a bit of 5x8, but they weren't absolutely bonkers. So I think in that sense that we definitely have we have some progress to make. Like, if you can see, a lot of these are 5x8, 3x20, but we haven't really got the 6 minute efforts yet. The things that really are like high intensity VO2 that really just whack up the threshold by like 5-10 watts in a 4 week block or something like that. So I think once we do that, it's going to be good. Big goal on the weekend, bucks 25, should be tasty. Got some more comm efforts to get. We've got three comms we're going to go for tomorrow, just as my last little efforts. I mean, you might as well make it fun. Like, the taper efforts, you want to make them really hard, but not too much. So instead of doing 5x8, We're going to do 3 times 8, but it's not really going to be 3. It'll be because some 8 minutes, sorry, some are going to be a little bit less. And then just easy days. These are both going to be about an hour. Pre-race ride and then whack bucks 25 and see how we are. We may have a oh yeah, we got some more goals coming, but we'll get into that later. So anyway, there we go. Difference in TT and road visit bike position. We'll just get the calculation out now. 332 divided by 315 is 5%. So not bad. Oh, we actually should have just done 7/332, shouldn't we, or something? Oh no. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. It's about 5% difference, so not crazy, not terrible. But anyway, not too bad. So anyway, cheers for watching. Hope you enjoy, and we'll see you in the next one.